I would like to present my study about textiles running in Northern and Central Europe, and I would like to talk about the case study of the early Bronze Age settlement Bruszczewo in Greater Poland, because I'm working with the textile ceramic from the settlement. But first of all, I would like to say that the conservation of textiles is favored by climate, soil condition, and location. But often there isn't such favorable coincidence. But ceramics, often well preserved, and so impressions of textiles on ceramic give us a chance to get information on textiles and textile techniques if the source material can be preserved. In my study, I define a textile as a processed organic material. So is it it is sufficient if an organic material is just twisted, for example? Textile ceramic is for me a kind of off-surface treatment, which can have a decorating and or symbolic and or technical function. But it can also be intentionally or accidentally. So with this definition of textile ceramic can be separated from, for example, group finish or quarter-ground solid textile or imitated textile. Now I would like to show you the material I'm working with of about 90 shirts from Bruszczewo. You can see the location. The settlement is what should be unity sculpture. And I have to say that I am just working with the material from the wet area below the ram. Material from the ram is edited by the Polish cooperation partners in Poznań. The material shows an almost regular distribution in the settlement part, and the textile ceramic is well inside of possible house structures as outside of them, though I can not tell you any analyse. So I would like to show you the material. The blue fabric is always a silicone imprint of the shirt. And a large part of the textile ceramic shows such twisted threads, on the one hand in a more parallel structure, and on the other hand in a more diffuse structure. And but they don't show any regular structure of a fabric, of a sheet material. So, for example, there are no weft threads, and so I cannot say that there is a connection. And so I thought it could be arise from single threads, whose connection cannot recognize. So maybe the ceramic was made on something like the skirt from Egbert from the early Bronze Age, but yeah, that's just one example. A second type of imprint just spun yarns. So maybe they are made by such fringes. And also we have detectable blind surface formations. So there are also twisted threads in a parallel structure, but now we can see a rough thread. Here you can see a rough thread that runs always over and under two rough threads. Another part of our impression shows possibly structures of tabby weave. So the weave structure is not visible, but it is possible that the last weft thread has been tightened so much that that only the rough threads are visible, so that we have such a stretched arrangement. A few shirts show structures which remind on Chipang technique, because the threads are crossed with each other and act rather diffuse. So sometimes the threads seem to interfere with each other. You can see the distribution of the types. There's a predominance of the twisted and spun yarns, parallel and diffuse structures. And to evaluate the textiles which happenings, I have to say that a large part of the imprints seem to show torn and frayed structures. So I'm assuming that the used textiles did not have the best quality. So let's come to the second part of my presentation, the textile ceramic in Northern and Central Europe. I collected shirts from the area around the Baltic Sea, and I was focused on the region from the southwestern part of Germany along the Baltic Sea to Finland, and the Carpathians built the natural border in the south. And but also I collected some shirts outside of the area of my work for comparison. And you can see that there are two clusters, but I think that's not saying so much because this can relate to the selection of shirts, because I just collected textile and Bruszczewo if I got a picture or drawing to determine the textile. So first let me introduce you to the shirts from my database through periods of time. As you can see in the temporal distribution, there is an increase from the Neolithic to the Bronze Age and the subsequent descent into the Iron Age. Already from the Upper Paleolithic are known some textile shirts from Pavlovka and Jastrowice, and from the Neolithic some shirts are also known, and they come from Brandenburg, and these are mainly the so-called Vinton ceramic. It's made by Russia, this kind of brass. In the early Neolithic, imprints are known especially from Germany and Poland, but also from the Czech Republic. And in the Middle Neolithic, textile ceramics also appears in the Baltics and Finland. You can see it. And from the Younger Neolithic to the Final Neolithic, the shirts with imprints in the sides and also the number of sites with textile ceramic increase. And in the Bronze Age, this period seems to be a booming period. So in the older Bronze Age, the distribution of textile ceramic has its climax, and imprints are also given in more areas. So maybe along with the invention and development of new technical methods, the importance of various textiles was increased in everyday life. And in the Younger and the Late Bronze Age, the proportion in the southern part of the area decreases. And in the Iron Age, the share of the ceramic decreases greatly. So already in the pre-Roman Iron Age, there's no longer textile ceramic in the southern part. And in the Roman Iron Age, there are only some isolated finds. The textile impressions come mainly from sediments. Some shards, however, come from graves, and only in a few cases textile ceramic was recovered from other contexts. In the temporal distribution, sometimes you can see an increase of the material over time period. For example, for the settlements, similar well. And also you can see that imprints from some features are used in certain time periods. For example, textile ceramic from single finds in context of earthworks are more found in the Neolithic, and shirts from cairns or ring frauds are more in the Iron Age. But however, most finds are from the transition to the Neolithic to the Bronze Age. The material of this study shows partly the same structures that have been found in Bruszczewo, but also other more complex techniques could be determined. So in addition to surface formations, tailing weave, scoring technique, and spun and twisted threads, I could determine rib weave, twirl weave, needle bending, roll pattern, and parallel plus radial platings. You can see that all textile techniques show similar temporal distributions, and there is a dominance in the older Bronze Age, and even the chronological rise can be seen again, for example here. But twisted threads have the largest share, but there are also a lot of tailing weave structures. And I can say that the distribution of the types in the area of work is very elderly. There are various theories concerning the manufacture of textile ceramic. For example, it is assumed that the textile ceramic was formed on a skirt, for example this or a similar textile. Others assume that textile ceramic can be produced in forms which were lined with textiles. So the finished vessel was then lifted with the help of the textile of the mold. Still other theories consider that myths were used for the production. And there is the theory that textile structures were preparing using a cord. So the cord was rolled over the vessel, and this method can imitate some textile techniques very well. in own experiments, I could find out how easy it is to imitate textile techniques. Mm-hmm. So for this impression, I have used a simple package tape. So it was a twisted part of plant material, which I wrapped around a rod. And yeah, you can see the burnt shirt and the silicone impression. And for this impression, I used twisted threads of wool, and I twisted them again, and then I wrapped it around a rod too. And yeah, in the silicone impression, you can see that it looks a little bit like this tabby weave with the web thread that has been tied so much that there are no web threads visible, such just the half thread. I showed to you the spinning in Bruszczewo. So we have this stretched arrangement. Finally, I would like to talk about functional and social aspects of textile ceramics. Here you can see some theories to interpret the functionality of textile ceramics. Theories which involve a practical function into consideration assume that textiles were used in ceramic production for farming and building up the farm. So, and the textile impressions could also be used for slowing down the drying process and thus prevent cracking of the vessel. And others assume that the imprints act as cooling while the surface is increased and enhance the emission of thermal energy of liquids, for example. And also the impressions have been used for surface roughening to achieve a better handling of the vessel. And in addition to practical functions, there are also approaches to believe that textile imprints were merely decorative. But I think linking aesthetics from today's perspective, however, I think it's very problematic. But in other approaches, a religious background is assumed, often according to ethnographic comparisons, and also a symbolic background is assumed. A particular variant of roughening of the ceramic could maybe highlight a certain content of the vessel. Also, textile impressions could information carriers or means of communication of a social group, for example, as a marker for social attributes such as age or gender. So, contrary to some theses, the textile ceramics is culturally determined. A demarcation based on the style group must have no territorial, cultural, or ethnical character. So, in my opinion, both practical, including ornamental and symbolic functions, cannot be separated. I think it is very possible that surface treatments such as textile ceramics can satisfy all categories simultaneously. And ethnological examples prove this. And furthermore, I think it is not possible to evaluate the aesthetics of a ceramic from today's perspective. So all in all, I would like to say that imprints on ceramics prove that textiles have been important in the production of ceramics. So the different interpretations also showing that textiles have always been presented, and partly it can be assumed that the textiles are rather being of inferior quality. With the ceramics from Bruszczewo, for example, it is evident that the used textiles could have been torn and frayed. So, however, the production of textiles in general is labor-intensive and time-consuming, and the value of this work and labor is reflected in the use of textiles again, which were used apparently secondarily. So perhaps we are dealing with a phenomenon of recycling of textiles. Thank you for your attention.